What's shaking, everybody? It's your boy, King of the Golden State, coming at you with another edition of the Wednesday Pile. A collection, or pretty much a best of a collection of comics I picked up from my LCS, my local comic book shop. And without further ado, guys, figure I'd get started. But before I do, without further ado, I just want to say thank you for those who are liking the last video having to do with my 300 subscriber contest. And yeah, like I said, ends on May 24th. And I'll say again, real quick, guys, if you guys have an entry you want to put in, be sure to put the link to your video in that into that contest video. So the link, so I can find you guys faster instead of just wandering around in the dark. So if you have a, I already seen one so far, and I've seen, I've only seen one so far, and it's a it was a really good video, but the problem was I just came across it. So be sure to put a link to your video on the video I posted, so I could just click on it instead of searching for it. It makes it easier because I don't want to overlook anybody and not put your entry down on the video for when the contest ends. So just a heads up, guys. But anyway, hope everyone's doing good. Hope everybody got what they wanted when it came to the NFL football draft that just happened. So yeah. And if you guys got a lump of coal, then I feel bad for you. But besides that, let's get started, guys. Pick these up. I'm still checking this out. It's actually pretty good. Suicide Squad number 16. And of course, the one on the left is a variant cover for this issue. And it's done by Lee Bormeo. I want to say Lee Bormeo. I may have that right. You know, I'm sure that's the, I'm assuming that's the enunciation. And yeah, it's a pretty much a cover swipe of the Harlequin. I forgot which Harlequin it was. It's an early Harlequin graphic novel, with instead of it being Lex Luthor here, it was the Joker. I believe it was. God, it escapes me. But I definitely know that, I'm sure you, as everybody else, would know that this is a cover swipe of Harlequin's debut. I believe it was her comic continuity debut. It wasn't like the Batman the animated series or Batman Adventures comic book. That was her debut. That was her full debut, her first debut. But this one is the one that was more of a continuity base. And then, of course, what you're seeing here is the cover swipe of that. So I thought this was pretty cool. I like that. You know, it kind of looked a little cracked out, in my opinion. But so pick that up. Also, decided to give this one a shot. Maybe this time around I'll look for the anti-Christian messages in here, or whatever it was. I forgot. I don't even know what the hell the story was. All I know is, like, I read the comic book. I sat down, read the comic book, put the comic book away, and that's it. I didn't hear anything about, you know, anti-messages about, you know, flimf, or any kind of bullshit. You know, I just sat back and read the comic book. I didn't hear anything about, oh man, they wrote like negative messages on like this pizza deli or pizzeria or whatever. It's like, come on, stop it. So, you know, I'll probably look for it in this one if they haven't edited it out already. So, and believe it or not, it's funny how fast these are coming, because the second issue is after the first issue, clearly, which was not too long ago, because the first issue was like 2-3 weeks ago. Now, the third issue, from what I was told from my LCS, is supposed to be coming out next week, which is surprising. I was like, that's kind of a change in speed, but whatever. I'm looking forward to reading it. So, got that. Also picked up X-Men Blue, another cover done by Arthur Adams, which I thought was a really cool cover, you know? And this one, X-Men Blue, you know, it's fine. There's nothing wrong with it. It's pretty good. So, picked that up. Also picked up the variant cover, which I got for cover price from my LCS. And this is a Humberto Ramos cover. I don't know about Humberto. I mean, I'm kind of, if there's anything I'm happy about is I got this for cover price, and I still think that this is like over, I still think that's like overpaying, but you know, it's a decent looking cover. It could be better. I don't know. I for me, I feel like I need more out of Humberto. I feel like this cover looks like it's been through a copy machine or something like that. I don't know. But yeah, I like it so far overall. You know, give it a good 6.5 out of 10. Also, picked up the second issue here of EXO Manowar. You know what, guys? Give this one a shot. I know many, you know, I know many variant titles aren't very popular, but I'm not crazy about variant. Valiant titles are very popular or anything these days. But give this one a shot. I read the first issue. I thought it was sneaky good. You know, in a way, I like using that term, sneaky good. But I'd say it's worth your time for reading it for about 25 pages or so. It's not, and like I said, it's not too bad. I also got a nice Bill Sienkiewicz variant coming, so you know, I'm looking forward to reading this as well. First issue was good. Speaking of first issues, this one's kind of quizzical, and I'm gonna read it, but it came out with another variant, and the variant is a Bill Sienkiewicz variant, and it's Underwinter by Ray Fox, and I'll pick anything by Sienkiewicz. You got to pick up, especially something like this. This is a sweet looking cover, you know. So, first issue was kind of weird, a little kind of quizzical. It was basically synopsis is a band is hired to perform at some party, but they had to perform blindfolded. Somebody peeked into the blindfold and saw some raucous shit. It was some weird shit, but so far, so good for me. I'm looking forward to reading this second issue. I'm assuming this one's going to be the variant since it's Bill Sienkiewicz. And Sienkiewicz kicks ass, in my opinion. Yeah. If you guys haven't met that guy, and if you guys are new to collecting comic books, one of the rules in collecting comic books, in my opinion, is to get anything Bill Sienkiewicz. Period. But anyway, check this out, guys. Give us a read. Also, as far as covers go, and I'm still a little behind on this, I just love the covers by Jeff DeCal when it comes to the Hulk. Especially when it's, you know, She-Hulk, but they call it a Hulk in this, just straight out the Hulk. I haven't gotten that far in this series yet, but I just love this cover. I mean, this is, talk about a woman PMSing. Pardon me, ladies, I'm sorry, but this is a kick-ass cover. When you're pissed, you know, don't piss off your girlfriend here, man. You know, just say yes to everything. Girlfriend, wife, what have you. This is a really cool cover. So, had to pick that up. Also, picked this one up. I didn't know this one was being solicited, but it's a mini series, and I figured it'd be worth a couple issues to check out if I ever got tired of it. But Batman and the Shadow. And, Batman and the Shadow have met before in earlier Batman issues. I believe it was earlier Batman. I don't think it was early Detective, but I believe, God, I want to say it goes back 30 years, because there was an issue with the Shadow guest starring in Batman, and just seeing this kind of brought that back. So, you know, it's being supported by DC and Dynamite, who I believe did the same thing with, they've been doing a lot with other things. I'm not sure if there's anything special that DC and Dynamite have together. I'm not sure if DC owns Dynamite, and this is why you're seeing stuff like this. But, you know, if you guys seen, I believe DC and Dynamite did Wonder Woman and the Bionic Woman. So, why not do Batman and the Shadow? So, you know, I'm going to see if I can give this one a shot. It looks pretty cool. Speaking of cool stuff, I thought this was going to happen just only one time, but this is happening again. And this is the whole Flash lenticular cover. So, got the regular cover, which is your plain old cover here. And then, of course, you got your lenticular cover, which is a dollar more. And, I'm not sure if you guys get that. There we go. And just changes out. And I kind of like this. And I was talking with but I hope they don't do too much of this. You know what I mean? Because they already done the variant covers for DC. But I just hope they don't do too much of this. Because I was talking to my guy at my LCS about how gimmick covers altogether, going back in the 90s, have kind of ruined comic collecting in a way. Because, while I was at my LCS, there was a guy and his girlfriend or wife or whoever came in there with him trying to sell some comic books to the owner. And it was a lot of the stuff you would normally see that keep coming back to comic shops, you know, trying to be sold. And it was a lot of the 90s stuff, a lot of gimmick stuff. And he had, like, maybe a small stack, and the best he could do was give him, like, I think about, God, I want to say $65, $80 bucks. Now's just being generous, because a lot of the stuff was a lot of gimmick covers, a lot of early 2000s stuff that everybody has, or everybody could pick up digitally, or pick up like in a dollar bin. So, you know, I just hope that DC or Marvel doesn't repeat that same problem with these variant covers going left and right. Because think about, like, say 10, 15 years from now, you know, you're trying to sell your variants off to comic shops, and comic shops say, no, we're not going to give you that much for it. We'll give you like a quarter for this issue, another 50 cents for this issue, and what have you. So, you know, hopefully, you know, stuff like this doesn't, in my opinion, ruin comics, you know, because comics had to take a serious step back with all the variants and stuff, being with the market being over flooded with it. That's how I feel. But actually, you know, Batman was good on this DC Rebirth. I hate to digress, but Batman was pretty good on this DC Rebirth, and I'm looking forward to reading The Flash. Boom. Also, guys, I got talked into this, and I was going to send him a copy, but his friend already got him a copy, so I don't feel too bad about it. But I got an extra copy of it. So this is a book called Namwoof. Never heard of it until Undisputed Frost, my boy Undisputed Frost. Shout out to your boy. Picked up, you know, and told me about this book, so figure I'd pick this up. I picked up a signed copy and an unsigned copy. Yeah, he didn't tell me too much about it. I mean, about what it's about and such, but figure I'd pick that up. And also, I figure I'd pick up another signed copy just for the hell of it. You know, I mean, I have no clue about what this is about, but I'm going to sit back and give it a read. And, of course, bag both of the other, and bag the rest. So, yeah, that's about it, guys. I don't know what else I got for you. I probably got some other videos I got to post. I know I'm running behind on a haul for what I bought from Silicon Valley Comic Con. I'm kind of slacking, I know. But anyway, guys, that's about it. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. That's what it looks like. Give me a comment down below on what you guys picked up from your comic shop. And yeah, if you haven't subscribed, please put your name down. Go ahead and subscribe to this channel. And also, like I said, there is that contest going on. It goes on until May 24th. And if you have an entry, like I said, put it down over in the video. Put your link down over at the video on which I posted it. So, I'm going. I'll talk to you later. Peace.